Hypex is a well-known OEM board provided for high-end audio amplifiers. In the part 2, we'll go through the most popular this company designs. Before we drill down in a topic, I would like to answer to one important question that I'm getting from my listeners. Why you are not providing actual measurements of OEM boards? The answer has two parts. And first one is legal. As a private person, you can do many things what is not allowed being part of the company. Once I'm working in a company, I do have a company-level responsibility and legal liabilities. Anything that comes out is kind of official. This is one of the reasons why mainly DIY people are publishing hands-on measurements, but professionals don't. You'll not find professionals from named companies publishing other companies' commercial units' test data. You can do internally whatever you want, but not publish official measurements. Second, when doing measurements, there are specific precise procedures how to do that. What filters should be used for noise and total harmonic distortion measurements, for example? In fact, when doing final unit official tests, it is done by third-party certification and measurement companies, typically state-owned with very advanced measurement equipment. Those are national or international certification centers, and process is expensive. Could you imagine small company having 100k worth total harmonic distortion measurement device being on shelf for about 99% of the time? Today we are measuring 4 digits after the comma with repeatable tolerance. Measurement equipment should have 10 times better resolution than device under the test. So, please don't ask for measurements, we can't provide them. But I will share learnings, concepts and conclusions as long as it will not influence other manufacturer business. For analysis, we will use company's official data. Good manufacturers providing honest and verified data. The question is how well we can read them. Let's take a look what Hypex is telling about themselves and try to read between the lines. Highest grade amplifiers. Digital sound processing solutions. They have their own factory. Extra flexibility. Better intellectual property protection. But it comes with the costs because production is located in a high labor cost region. Company maintains distribution network. Two-tiered sales engine working through dealers and system builders network. What they do? Class D amplifier design and manufacture. Yes, famous brand in high-end designs. Switching mode power supply. Design and manufacture. Yes, good lineup and good price-quality ratio. Creating DSP solutions. Do some, but not the strongest player. Extensive research and development regarding various high-end audio and DSP designs. Yes. Analog circuit design. Yes. In-house support for all customers, professionals and the AI people, sure. The applications. Active loudspeakers. Just entering the market. There are large players and super strong competition. Studio-based solution, the same. Pro market is oversaturated with strong players and cost-optimized good solutions. Check the studio monitor market. Hypex is a niche player. Maybe we will see interesting designs in the future. Home theater. Haven't seen in mass market yet. Amplifiers for audio film market. Dominant player with number of partners. Live sound purpose. A bit too expensive a too narrow product line to become a dominant player. Maybe in future with a strong investor. Music instrument applications, the same. Overall, Hypex is great and innovative company coming in the market with amazing and good quality products. Currently dominant in the audio film world where final quality bits and pieces counting. And this is where most of the do-it-yourself audience wants to be. Build something very good by themselves, enjoy a leading-edge result, keeping spendings reasonable. Hypex professional lineup smallest brother NC122MP. This product line has been built by the book and it is a top-notch design among Class D amplifiers. You can read product features by yourself. I would mention PFC circuits even for small power boards. You will not find them in competitor design. Automatic switching between 110 volts and 220 volts mains. But you should be ready to pay price for greatness. The direct competitor of this board is Icepower 125A62. They have the same market. I don't see many DI designs with this low power module. Typically, DI audience is aiming for a higher power version, and it is a clever move with better price-performance ratio. There you can see specs in details. Everything is great except output, where we are a bit shy with the power. There's a closer look to the board itself. And I agree to each line written below. One important note before we go and read board description. Do you remember picture from the part 1? Yes, basic principle how class D is working. When designing class D amplifiers, you need to add negative feedback. And there are two ways how can you do that. Either take signal prior output filter there, or after output filter at speaker output, and include it in the feedback loop. If you include output filter in the feedback loop, you will formally get better standard measurements. But there is no free cheese for the mice. You just change the place where artifacts are visible, not changing overall system performance. Your depth of the feedback has variations and artifacts are visible prior the filter. There is answer to often asked question, is Hypex better than Icepower? Hypex is not better at amplifier stage where characteristics seems kind of better. It is just a different way how to implement negative feedback. But Hypex is superior due to the excellent power supply architecture with PFC and resonant tank switching mode power supply. That majority of Icepower budget boards doesn't have. How much better? That's another story. Board official description and pay attention to this sentence. Chief distinguished feature are flat frequency response irrespective of load impedance. Nearly frequency-independent distortion behavior and very low radiated and conducted electromagnetic interference. Control is based on a phase shift controlled self-oscillated loop backtaking feedback only at the speaker output. Yes, measurement curves will look better and audiophile community is aware about that. It is working like a good differentiator when positioning products in a market. NC502 MP is my favorite Hypex product. It is sweet point for quality and price. Once I said a question which board to choose to build superior amplifier, and this is my recommendation. Sufficient power, perfectly balanced for high quality requirements and needs. You can get about 2x300 W perfect operation range with some headroom. Description is similar to all boards in this lineup, and we will not stop there. There is board specifications. Everything is great. Power is mentioned at 1% distortion, but in the part 1 we agreed that only range up to 0.1% counts. So this is a good 300 W plus with 150 W power headroom stereo amplifier board. NC100HF is add-on board optimized for tweeting and three-way speaker configuration. NC100HF specifications. Everything is perfect, including extra low noise floor and total harmonics distortion. Small application sample is below the specifications. Let us take a closer look to building blocks and try to find out, are there some familiar from the part 1? Mains input and filter. Hypex cared about electromagnetic compatibility and made input filter with two inductivities. Added inductivity is a cost. Two relay switches. I do not have schematics, so that's my guess that one is shunting inrush current circuits to provide maximum power to the power supply, and second is a part of automation switching between 110 volts and 220 volts. Primary side high voltage storage capacitors should be connected after PFC circuits. PFC inductor. High power capable. We are looking to more than 1 kilowatt capable power supply components. I guess those are resonant tank capacitors. Mains transformer with gate driver transformer. Standby low power flyback power supply. Secondary mains voltage rectifier capacitors. A lot of them set in parallel to reduce electrolytic capacitors internal resistance and be capable to release maximum instant current. Important. Nice, powerful, proprietary output filter inductors. part of Hypex innovation. Balanced input circuits. Perfect design all around. Excellent engineering work. Any low lights? Maybe price. If price is not an issue, then almost perfect. But don't forget that we are dealing with 1 kW design. Heat dispatch is part of your design and part of your challenges. NC502 is worth drilling down in specifications. Let's go through all of them and I will stop for spotlights. We already discussed highlights, features and applications. We skip this summary and move to specifications. The first is power specification. You can see that NC502MP can work in 110 volts countries like US and Japan, as well as 220 volts countries located in European Union and Russia. There are two important notes. First, about automatic switching between the mains voltage. Second, about melting fuse soldered inside the board for total failure protection. It simplifies integration because you don't need a fuse holder for the caches. It's a small thing, but kind of saving a lot of time. Standby 5 volts switching mode power supply. Nothing fancy. Small power to meet industrial standby power requirements for high power units. Main switching mode power supply. Efficiency about 92%. It's great. But pay attention, I already mentioned that we are dealing with 1 kW design. Switching mode power supply idle power consumption is 17 watts. That means there is generated heat even at a very low output audio signal. In addition, there will be about 13 watts extra from amplifier power stage. Think about a heat dispatch during the design process. Don't try to assemble your amplifier in very small sealed box. What else do we have? 1 amp capable auxiliary voltage to make stabilized preamplifier power supply voltage for about plus minus 12 volts. Amplifier section. Everything is great among the best of the best. Signal to noise ratio outstanding. Total harmonic distortion excellent. Efficiency good. Idle losses 6.2 watt per channel, total 13 watts. Constant output impedance for all frequencies. This is a place where measurements are kind of tricky. Once you have the output inductor, our output impedance varies from frequency. In Hypex design, inductor is included in the feedback loop and measures better than competitors. But it is not improving overall system performance. Good input circuits with a high input impedance at 47 kilo ohms. Typically, such systems have 20 kilo ohm input impedance in a balanced connection. Designed for 4 ohm load with capability to work with 2 ohms as well. Good for passive crossover speakers with large impedance variations. Total harmonic distortion grabs looks excellent. I think this grab is killer for audiophile community to prove that Hypex products have the best performance. Frequency response within 0.5 decibels at 20 kHz for any load. Perfect. A low output impedance without rises at high frequency, what would be logical have an output inductor filter. Magic of negative feedback from speaker output. Low level signal total harmonic distortions below 0.005% for 2, 4 and 8 ohms. Excellent. Even at half power, total harmonic distortion is very low. It will be hard to find a class AB amp with such a parameters. There is one more board worth to mention, NC500 OEM. This is amplifier board without a power supply, with high power capability. It has the same architecture as NC502MP, but has some specifics, leaving room for the highest possible performance implementations. The quality of preamplifier buffer circuits is critical for super performance audio amplifier. Hypex designers left some freedom for system integrators, giving extra flexibility of design. When properly designed, you can build a super quality system. There is a solid market for people who want the best of the best. In practice, you can build a reference system for reasonable money. Will you hear the difference with NC502 in blind tests? Somebody should make them and publish the results. I have no idea. I guess that people not hear the difference. Both units are at the leading edge and speakers are far behind with the production tolerance. I will click through the specifications without the comments. Everything is great. I included those slides to keep the information one place. You can stop video at the right place and study them by yourself. This is an interesting document. Frequently asked numbers. I mentioned before that there is no free cheese for the mice. You can't gain something simply by taking a negative feedback signal from speaker output. Design elements are the same and physics apply accordingly. Measurement graphs are so excellent that some people with electronic knowledge started asking for the numbers. And here you have it. Summarizing, Hypex designs are excellent, but they are not outperforming ice power in real application scenarios. If you would ask me, could I recommend Hypex board for a good amplifier designs? Sure, this is leading edge technology. This is leading edge quality. Will it be more expensive than alternatives? I think yes, but no more than 30%. Let's take a look at some practical building examples. From the left, monster design with two pieces of 1 kW capable power supplies. Two fully separated channel design. Maybe a bit overkill for a home user. Design is not optimized for costs. Dual monoblock architecture. Costs are more than 1k euros. Side by side, Purify left evaluation board and NC500 design. From an engineering point, Purify design I like more due to the balanced usage of power supply and amplifier circuits. 3 kW boards in a small box, they are in sauna. Design is not optimized for heat dispatch. The same, 1 kW in a small box. Those are marginal designs and you can't utilize your amplifier full potential. Much better design with airflow through the caches. Also good design for home user with a larger box and some vents. Multi-channel version, just thinking about the usage scenario. For home cinema it's overkill, for stereo music a bit too much as well. Interesting design where compact size has been achieved, installing the board in a thick wall casted box. Pay attention that in this case System Builder is using a lower power board modification. Hypex professional boards are not easy to find in open market. At the moment of this video, only NC250 series stereo board was available on eBay for a price about $300. Those are Hypex Professional active speaker driver boards with integrated DSP. Active speakers have about 4 times more efficiency than speakers with passive crossover. And even 100 watt amps may drive your woofer with confidence for home usage scenarios. For the stereo system, you need pair of those boards. There is Hypex 3-way speaker driver lineup. For the active speaker project, I would choose the 250 watt version. It is kind of sweet point for home usage. When you get rid of passive crossover and move to active speaker architecture, you are moving to the next quality and performance system. Just properly tune DSP and you can achieve high tolerance audio reproduction. For 1 kW system, you should think about a heat dispatch. There is evidence that for reliable operation, Hypex implemented forced ice cooling. What else we see in industrial design? Hypex implemented extra filter circuits to meet demanding industrial electromagnetic compatibility certification requirements. Once you are going into the pro market, small things matter. In the next part, part 3, we will drill down into ice power product lineup.